Hello, I just wanted to spend a few minutes to show you how to make a very cheap and effective night vision system for your air rifle. And I've managed to cobble together a system for £28.36 for all the actual bits that you need to get the night vision to your scope. Obviously it's going to cost you a little bit more than that if you need extra bits, but I reckon if you're like me and you hoard things, if you spend a lot of time scouring the house, you'll find most of the extra bits you need in order to put the thing together. So the component you'll already have for the system is your scope on your rifle. This one's a Tesco scope, I've had it a number of years now. Very, very good scope. So in order to actually get night vision, you need to be able to look through the telescope with a camera that can see things in infrared. And you also need to be able to see what the camera's looking at, so you need a screen as well. The first thing I bought was a camera. The camera is designed to go into the bumper of a car. I got that from eBay. It was shipped from China and cost me £6.59. The camera is actually very, very small. You can just see how small the camera is there. It's a 6mm lens, and a 6mm lens won't do. You won't be able to see through the scope with a 6mm lens, so you're going to have to buy another lens in order to get the system to work. It comes with a long RCA lead, and I've not used that lead actually. I use a shorter one, but if you didn't have a lead, it would do the job and save you from actually buying one. So £6.59 will get you the camera. Now remember, I said that a 6mm lens is no good. You're going to need something that's bigger than that. I actually bought a 12mm lens. You can pick them up for £2.99 from eBay as well, from China. I'll show you that now. That's a 12mm lens. I'll explain what you do with that in a minute. So £6.59 buys you the camera, £2.99 will buy you the lens, and then obviously you need a screen in order to actually see what the camera's looking at. That's the screen I ended up buying. I think it's a 5-inch screen or a 4-inch screen or something. Doesn't really matter, any screen will do. But I paid a little bit more for that one because I wanted one that was a little bit bigger than the smaller ones, and that cost me £12.83. That also came from China, from eBay. And there are plenty of screens to choose from. So, those four items, right, will allow you to see things in infrared through your scope, so long as you've got an infrared light source. But obviously most people don't have an infrared light source. For me, it wasn't a problem because I've got infrared cameras in the chicken coop where I'm actually watching what's going on, and I could see fine without a torch. But I actually bought a torch as well, which cost me £5.95. And that torch there is an infrared torch. I don't know whether you can, let me turn it on for you. It's an infrared torch. It's not one of the laser pointers which people are using there that gets a long distance, but for fairly short range stuff, 20 yards, 30 yards, it's fine. Without, you won't have any problems with it. So that whole setup, the torch, the screen, the lens and the camera, came to £28.36. Now, that will get you going shooting in the dark, but what you've got to do is try and find a way to get all that connected to that. My first step was to actually find something that fits over the end of the scope. The second thing was to actually find something that fit inside of that, and luckily enough for me, this piece, which just screws off there, was a reasonable fit into the back of there. So they were the first two, probably the most difficult things to get hold of. It took me about 2 or 3 hours to find something that was suitable to fit on the end. And then what you need to do now is you need to get the camera inside of there. I actually turned a cylinder on the lathe, which was a reasonable fit inside there, and then to make it a nice snug fit, I actually turned a couple of notches on the cylinder and put two O-rings on, which just made it a snug fit inside. Now you guys probably won't have the ability to do that, but you can do it with a square piece of wood exactly the same. All you need to do is to draw around the inside . So you can see the circumference of the inside of the pipe, And again, this is really rough, but it'll do the job. Just work out the widest point so you've got the full diameter. It doesn't have to be perfect. And draw a line through. And again, I'm just going to do this by eye anyway. And again, at 90 degrees to that. So you end up with effectively a rough crosshair, and then just join where those lines cross the circumference, like so. Now that is very rough, but it doesn't need to be really accurate, because what you do is you actually add two or three mil onto the edge and cut it big. Once you've actually cut that off, then you just sand the corners off until it fits snug inside the tube. And then that will give you something to mount the camera onto. One thing I forgot to mention, that the camera also comes with a hole saw. So that makes things very, very easy when it comes to mounting a camera inside whatever it is you've got inside your tube. So all I did was I turned a cylinder on the lathe, and then I drilled out the centre with the hole saw. But you could do exactly the same with your square piece of wood. You know, just find the best centre. It doesn't have to be perfect, but as good as you can. And drill it out with a hole saw. And then the camera, once you've taken this little cap off, just slides in. And that is your camera mounted. The camera pushes in like so. Then I screw this on the top. Which just makes it nice and neat. Now, like I said, that 6mm lens, right, you will not be able to see anything through the scope with that. You need to get either a 12, I've been told a 16mm lens is better, but I couldn't get hold of a 16mm lens. This is a 12mm lens, and it's okay. That lens screws out, the new lens screws in. Now I've put some PTFE tape on there because it was very slack. Plumber's tape, and that just actually takes the slackness away, because it only needs two or three threads on this for it to be in focus. So with that particular setup, you can actually get the camera connected to your scope, and then all you need to do then is actually fix the screen onto the scope. What I intended to do was to actually put a scope ring upside down on the scope and super glue it on. I've got a GoPro camera, I decided to use a handlebar mount, or try a handlebar mount, to see whether that would work, and it works brilliantly. So you can pick these up for £2.99. I've just had a look on eBay. The handlebar mount just clips over the telescope like so. Just clamp that on. The screen itself comes with a mount, and I actually super glued a GoPro tripod mount onto the base of that, and that just literally slots on. You can bolt it on, but I just slot it on. So what you need to do then is connect your larger diameter tube to the back of the scope, and like I said, I've got electrical insulation tape on there to make that a snug fit. Now, you do need to be able to move that around slightly in order to get the thing centred. But you can see that's a nice tight fit, there's no issues with that. I'll push the camera into the end of this tube. Like so. That slots in there. That is basically the night vision setup. As I said earlier, you need a 12 volt transformer. Both the camera and the screen come with power leads, but they're just like bare wires at the end. I snipped the adapter off the end of the transformer and soldered the two wires onto the positive and negative side of the transformer to give me power. But if you need to buy a transformer, you can pick up a transformer for £2.99 from eBay, that will do the job. Or you can pick up a battery for about £7.49, which means you're totally portable outside. But I'll just show you this system working now. So basically plug in the power. You've got to power up the camera and the screen, and then I've got a shorter cable, but you can use a long one that comes with the camera. Right, I just hang that over the post there, and then you connect the two together. Right, and you can see you've got an image there. You can actually adjust the position of the camera.